Hi, my name is Jack, and this channel I talk about personal finance, adulting, and self-improvement. And today in this video, let's talk about the old money advice that's not applicable to the current financial landscape anymore. I have probably covered a lot of personal finance topics and ideas that I'm comfortable talking about and as a circle of competence ko. And maubos na yon, that's why I would like to crowdsource sa inyo ng mga topics sa personal finance that you're interested for me to talk in this channel. So yun, please let me know them in the comment section down below. Okay, back to the main topic ng video na to. Now, let's talk about the old money wisdom that used to work for our parents and grandparents na hindi na masyado nag-work for us ngayon. Number one on my list are all loans, credits, debts, and utang are bad. Generally, that is a good rule of thumb, but in today's age, meron na tayong mga tinatawag na good debts. Siguro ang karamihan sa atin ang tanong nila sa sarili na is, kailan pa naging okay mangutang? So kasi siguro yung kanilakihan natin is yung pangungutang is pangtawid ng pang-araw-araw na buhay. So pwedeng pambili ng pagkain, pang-tisyon ng anak, or pambili ng something na hindi naman talaga kailangan. So generally, those are bad ways of using loans. The right way of using loans is gamitin mo siya as your leverage. Pwede mo siyang pang-start ng capital in your business, or kaya naman just do something na magpuput ng money back in your pockets. Having a specific set of skill plus capital money is one of the best combinations that you could have. For example, magaling ka mag-take ng photos pero wala ang sarili camera, you could take a loan and buy your own camera. So, pwede ka mag-set ng sarili mong photography business. Or kaya naman, marunong ka mag-code pero wala ang sariling computer or laptop, you could take a loan and buy your own personal computer or laptop. Or kaya naman, marunong ka magluto or magaling ka magluto pero wala ang sariling lutuan or wala kang ingredients. So, pwede ka rin mag-take ng loan pang bili ng mga lutuan or ingredients, and you could use it as a leverage to start a business. Getting a loan to supplement your skill is one of the proper ways of using a loan. Or kaya naman, pwede rin gamitin mo siya pang buy and sell. For example, you want to buy real estate, then ibibenta mo siya at a higher price. Pwede din yon. Or kaya naman, bibili ka ng real estate, then paparentahan mo siya for recurring income. So, pwede din yon. Or kaya naman, other buy and sell na products, pwede bumili ka ng shoes. So, yung kapatid ko, bumibili ng mga sneakers online, and then ibibenta niya din yon over the internet at a higher price. So, sa mga babae, you could use yung mga clothing haul. So, pwede din yon. So, those are one of the ways na pwede mong gamitin yung loan to make good money. Those are just some examples that I'm familiar about when it comes to using loans. But if you have your own personal story, please kindly share them in the comment section down below kasi hindi mo naman talaga alam kung sino yung makakabasa nun, and that might change somebody's life. So please let me know your story, your personal loan story in the comment section down below. Number 2, since nagsimula na rin tayo sa mga utang, let's follow it up with something na related, which is yung credit card. Dito, there are two school of thoughts. Yung una is never get a credit card kasi mababawon ka lang sa utang. And the other one is get a credit card because of its benefits and perks pagka meron kang ginagamit na credit card for your transactions. Ako, personally, I have a credit card and I use it a lot. Pero when I was first offered for the first time, sobrang hesitant ako i-activate yung credit card ko. So parang it took me 6 months, half a year before ko siyang i-activate. But after that, yun ay number one option payment ko more than cash and debit. The number one benefit that I was able to take advantage of sa credit card is I was able to use it to help me in my cash flow. Siguro kasi yung if you really use it wisely based on yung mga cut-off dates ng card mo, you could defer your payments by 1 month. For me, as a freelancer, wala akong consistent income and consistent money. So for me, ang laking tulong ng credit card because it helps me manage and control yung mga expenses ko, and I was able to put it on months where I have the most money. You could also earn points pagka ginagamit mo yung credit card mo for your transactions, and you could convert those points into dining experience, into mileage, and into other accommodation expenses. Other ways that you could take advantage of your credit card is you could pay yung mga high expensive items ng installment. So instead of parang bibiglain mo yung expenses mo with one blow, so masakit yun into your cash flow, you could just chop it into installments using your credit cards. I remember there's a comment that I received na mas okay pa rin daw magbayad ng spot up cash kasi pwede kang mag-ask ng discount. Which is true, totoo yun. Pagka nagbayad ka ng spot up cash sa mga mahal na bagay, pwede ka mag-ask ng discount. And surely, binibigay naman sa iyo ng mga dealer or yung nagbebenta. But the problem nga with this is, baka ma-liquidate ka. Meaning, pag binayaran mo ng buo yung binili mo, hindi mo matansya yung expenses mo. Yung other expenses mo na, ay, meron ka palang ganitong babayar and wala ka ng enough cash para bayaran yon. Or pwede din mo din sabihin na yung opportunity cost. I'll explain more about opportunity cost later. Having and using your credit card wisely helps you build a good credit score para if mag-ask ka ng loan sa mga banks, pwede ka makakuha ng mas decent na interest rate sa mga loans mo if you have a good credit score. Now, let's talk about the cons or constraints of having a credit card. Siguro number one dito is having annual fees. So, ito yung binabayaran mo kada taon for having a credit card. Pero pwede mo naman ito ipawave din sa bank mo, kaya lang they usually ask you to spend a certain amount of money within a time period. And second dito na constraint siguro is yung high interest rate pagka nagkaroon ka ng late payments. So, ito yung mga dahilan kung bakit nababaon sa utang ibang mga taong nagka-credit card kasi wala silang control in their expenses and pinababayaan nila may balance sila every month, which pag nag-snowball yun ng mas palaking utang because of the interest of the credit card. Again, I just want to share the good sides and bad sides of having a credit card kasi growing up, I was only thought yung bad side ng credit card. So, yun, just want to parang inform everyone of the good side and bad side of having a credit card. Okay, number three, a home is a form of investment. But before we proceed to the next topic, kindly smash the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Number three, your home is an investment. Siguro, a lot of Filipinos, napakalaking milestone nito, especially when you're in your age 20s to 30s. Having your own car and having your own home is a really, really big milestone that parang everybody wants to have. Pero I think we should kind of reconsider this kind of thinking or your mindset kasi your home or a house is not an investment. A house is not an investment in the context na it doesn't put money back in your wallet. When you use a real estate property as a place where you live, so ginagamit mo siya, it puts a roof above your head, gives you a comfortable place to live in. Pero that's just it. Spending too much money on it is not a good use of money. If you are familiar with the book Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki, this is something he really emphasized in the book that a house or a home is not an investment.
In 1997, when I released Rich Dad, Poor Dad, that book caused a bit of an upset because I said, your house is not an asset.
If you wanted to turn a home into an investment, kailangan mo siyang i-flip or ibenta. So, bibili mo siya at a lower price and ibibenta mo siya at a higher price. So, yun yung flip. Or kaya naman, pwede din use it as a rental property. So, meron kang recurring income dito on a consistent basis. So, that's how you turn a home or a house into an investment. Some may argue na tumataas pa rin naman yung value ng house na titira mo, so it's still an investment. Which is true, totoo. Tumataas pa rin yung value ng house na titira mo. Especially pag maraming construction or maraming improvements na nangyayari na malapit dun sa area mo. But the thing is, hindi mo naman makukuha yung potential value ng house mo kung hindi mo siya ibibenta. Which is, hindi mo talaga siya ibibenta kasi nga dun ka nakatira and ginagamit mo siya. Again, I just want to give different context and perspective about a home as an investment. Number 4, buying a house is always better than renting a home. The initial argument dito is sayang pera pagka-renta kasi para ka nagtatapon ng pera kasi bayad ka ng bayad ng rental income pero you're not owning a piece of property. Pero let's give a more parang perspective or a deeper context into this argument. Buying a home obviously costs a lot more initially kasi you have to pay a huge down payment compared to renting, diba? So let's parang give context muna to opportunity cost because ito yung bagay na you will be losing pagka malaki yung pinut mong money into a home. So let's talk about more sa opportunity cost para maintindihan nyo or ma-explain ko ng maayos yung nawawala sa inyo when you put a huge amount of money as an initial payment for buying a home. So yung tanong sa opportunity cost is, will putting a huge amount of my money in a home is the best use of my money? Kasi madami ka naman talagang pwedeng paggamitin ng money. You could use it somewhere else. Pwede ipang start mo siya as a capital in your business or kaya naman pwede mo siyang gamitin sa stock market, which is the potential to make your money grow. And parang it makes more sense than freezing your money over a home. Repairs and maintenance is something that you wanted to consider when you're buying a home. Kasi there are a lot of unexpected repairs and maintenance na nangyari when you're owning a home. So pwedeng tumataas na yung mga tiles mo, kailangan ng palitan, or kaya naman yung roof mo, kailangan ng i-repair or i-upgrade. So yun, that's something that you also wanted to consider when you're buying a home. And pagka nagrenta ka lang, hindi mo sagot yun, bahala na yung landlord for this kind of expenses. Lastly, flexibility. So when you buy a home, nakatali ka na dun sa place ng property mo. So mahirap nang lumipat pagka bumili ka ng home kasi nabili mo na eh. And mahirap ibenta yung real estate property, hindi siya ganun kadaling liquidate. Unlike pagka nag-rent ka lang, once the contract is over, pwede mo nang iwanan or umalis ka na lang dun sa tinitirahan mo. Especially pagka hindi mo gusto yung environment that surrounds your home. Just to sum this part up, there are always advantages and disadvantages for owning a home and renting a home. I just want to give a shed of light na hindi laging patapon yung pera when you're renting a property. Number 5, educational plan. So before, usong-uso pa yung mga pre-need plan. So siguro may mga kilala ka pa kayo, or ako kasi meron pa akong classmate that was able to get yung insurance claim niya dun sa educational plan niya. So yun, but in today's age, wala na yung mga pre-need plans yan kasi madami na nagsara before.
2004, Price Plans Incorporated. 2005, TPG Corporation. Nagka-problema din sa pondo ang Cap of College Assurance Plan at Permanent Plans Incorporated noong 2007.
So yung mga nakakuha na lang ngayon, so sila na siguro yung mga last na pwedeng mag-file ng claims ng mga educational plan. So this is not applicable in today's age. So ngayon, ang ginagawa na lang ng mga tao or yung mga nagpe-prepare for their kids' education or college plan is nag-invest sila sa mga equities fund or sa mga stock market or pwedeng sa real estate or yung pag-ibig MP2. So doon na lang nila nilalagay yung pera nila for their kids' college. So wala na ngayon yung mga kagaya before na magbabayad ka lang at certain amount of money and sure na na sila na yung bahala sa pag-aaral ng anak mo. So ngayon, hindi na ganun. You have to really study the market and use your money wisely and invest your money wisely. Number 6, retirement. As a 90s kid, yung tinuro sa akin concept ng retirement is you have to work for a well-known company. So, kailangan mo mag-stay doon. Huwag kang lilipat. You have to climb the corporate ladder and aalis ka lang when you're ready in your retirement age, which is yung 60s mo. Then, you'll get your big fat retirement check and then you'll travel the world and build your dream house. Pero hindi na ganun yung case ngayon. So what happened ngayon is mas okay pa mag-job hop ka because that will increase your salary mo. It's more effective. And ngayon naman, hindi mo na kailangan ng mahal na pagta-travel because travel is now on a budget. So hindi mo na kailangan antayin pa yung 60s mo to travel the whole world. One thing that really concerns me sa mga retirees ngayon. So I have a friend na nag-retire na yung parent niya. And ako, meron din ako mga kilala na pa-retire na yung parent niya, which is the same as my parents, so pa-retire na sila. One common denominator sa kanila is yung hobby nila pag nag-retire na sila is home renovation, which really concerns me. For me, this is scary kasi the best time to do it is when you have your recurring income. Kaya nga lang, hindi nila magawa yun before because they don't have the budget kasi nga, pero pa sila mga pinag-aaral na anak. E ngayon, nag-graduate na yung mga anak nila, tsaka sila nag-renovate ng home nila. But the problem is, yung recurring income nila is already gone. And for me, this is counterintuitive kasi you don't want to be an aggressive spender when your recurring income is already gone. Another part of retirement that I wanted to touch is staying at home and doing nothing is doing more harm than good. For this argument, this is just based solely on my intuition. So kasi napapansin ko lang, when people stops working, hindi nila masyadong ginagamit yung brain nila. So hindi sila masyadong nagdating critically. And parang dun dumadating yung mga mental problem, yung mga old mental illnesses. So parang dun nagka-come in yun when they stop working and when they stop thinking critically. So for me, I think we should start redefining retirement where titigil na tayong mag-work and we're just going to stay at home. Whatever life stage you are at, you should always have something to look forward to na gising ka, excited to wake up every single day. More than having enough money that would last you a lifetime pagka nag-retire ka, I think it's also important to figure out your Rushmore pagka nag-retire ka na.
What's the secret, Max?
The secret?
Yeah, well, you seem to have it pretty figured out.
Secret? I don't know. I think you just gotta find something you love to do and then do it for the rest of your life. For me, it's going to Rushmore.
That's it. Hope you appreciate this video. Please don't forget to smash the like button if you like this video. And kindly subscribe if you're not yet a subscriber. And let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. So yun lang. See you in the next video. Bye!